It's the burning question for kids around our state. Is the Easter Bunny allowed to deliver his treats this year? Nine's intrepid reporter Mike Dalton went out to confront our leaders.
It was this letter from little Ollie Fisher to the state's highest ranked politician that captured the concerns of a generation of self-isolating New South Welshmen.
I was wondering if this means that the Easter Bunny is not allowed to come on Sunday morning.
For tens of thousands of kids across the state, the question remained, in this time of coronavirus, will we still get Easter eggs? Kids in the West in Western Australia knew they had no dramas.
I've just signed a special exemption for the Easter Bunny.
And kids in the East in New Zealand were assured all was okay.
You'll be pleased to know that we do consider both the Tooth Fairy and the Easter Bunny to be essential workers.
And Australia's chief medical officer had no issue with his vocational classification.
He's a solo operator and is an essential service.
I decided to go to the top, to the Premier. What assurances can you give these future voters that the Easter Bunny can deliver this Easter unimpeded?
The Easter Bunny is exempt. The Easter Bunny is allowed to visit homes and is also allowed to deliver chocolates, but you have to ask your parents or anyone in your household whether or not you're allowed to have the chocolates.
I double-checked with the state's leading law keeper as well.
Easter Bunny will travel safely in New South Wales. Can't guarantee that out of New South Wales, so the bunny can stay here and look after us.
And I confirmed all is good for this Sunday with the state's Easter Bunny liaison officer, Taronga Zoo's Paul Hare.
So you're Paul Hare?
That's right, Paul Hare.
Hare.
Hare. It's going to be business as usual.
Families were relieved to hear the news.
As long as he puts on gloves and a mask, we'll be all right, and the eggs are wrapped.
Mike Dalton, Nine News.